Mr. Pillai will be speaking on extremely vital issue that concerns the entire mankind and also its future. Sustainability is not just any more a cliche, but it is something which has become extremely important, because the earth itself, and which means the existence of mankind itself, is facing challenges, and therefore this becomes an extremely important issue. And Mr. Jeevaraj Pillai will be talking to us about sustainable packaging, because packaging again is the largest sector. Mr. Jeevaraj Pillai is very well known in the industry, and he hardly needs an introduction, and giving his introduction is like showing a lamp to the sun. But I still would like to discharge the responsibility of sharing more information about him. He is the joint president at India's biggest flexible packaging company, which has also the largest international presence, both through exports to over, I think, nearly 200 countries, and plants in five continents. Five continents, is that right, Mr. Pillai?
Yep.
In five continents. And is arguably one of the top few companies in the world, UFlex. UFlex truly put India on the world map in a way like no other packaging materials company has. Mr. Pillai has 35 years of experience in technology production, project development, is well renowned for this. On the sustainability front, he has been working for the past 10 years on addressing the issue of the damage caused to the environment by plastic litter, by implementing various measures, including recycling and of multi-layer plastics. He has been actively involved in the development of viable biodegradable options for the packaging industry, including that under litter conditions, which means not under special conditions of heat, temperature, and pressure, and things like that. So I think that's a huge achievement. And monopolymer-based barrier and non-barrier laminate structures. His contribution in implementing the energy curing technology in flexible packaging resulted in a substantial reduction in carbon footprint. He has presented papers on sustainability, plastic packaging, and environment, moving towards a circular economy, application of e-beam technology, anti-counterfeiting options, and antimicrobial films, to name a few. He has also won awards from AIMCL, FPA, and DuPont for sustainable developments. I now invite Mr. Pillai to provide us with his insights into the important issue of sustainable packaging. Mr. Pillai, it's yours.
Takeshji, as you had rightly said, actually, sustainability is a very loosely used word, and most people who are the actual stakeholders, they seldom understand actual meaning of sustainability. Some call it recycling, some call it waste management, some call it some source reduction and things like that. So in the brief time which I have, about 7 or 8 minutes, I would like to make some clarifications on sustainable packaging. In such a short time, it will not be possible to discuss any technology or any particular product which will be the future sustainable product. But by and large, we'll try and make it clear to the audience that when we talk about sustainability, what actually it means. I'll roll back to 1992 when we were putting up a biggest plant in the country for manufacturing flexible packaging material. Those days our per capita consumption of packaging was very low. It was like 2 or 3 kilograms per capita, as against 100 kgs for United States and 110 kilograms for Japan and all those things. So the first thing which came to our mind is that how will you handle when the per capita consumption grows to the level of the developed countries, how will we handle the waste? So imagine a manufacturing company, all the companies in the country till late 2010s, we are practicing only linear economy. We seldom worried about the waste. We only worried about resource efficiencies, productivity, scaling up, and things like that. So this was the time we started worrying about the waste. Sustainability is very much part of our DNA, and that makes all of our employees and all of us together working on sustainable solutions. So let me just clarify. The sustainability is very simple terms. Would, if you can address the 3 R's, you know, 3 R's everyone knows, you know, even in the school we used to be taught 3 R's means reduce, reuse and recycle. So I've been fortunate enough to go through the sustainability policies of many good countries, many Western countries, China. Generally, they will cover all the three. Generally, they will only talk about steps, actions and policies which are under the umbrella of 3 R's. We are also fortunate to have a policy document from the Government of India now, after a long time, the new PWM rules and the new EPR rules. They are also talking about 3 R's, you know, in some way or the other. So to understand sustainability, we must understand the 3 R's. And if we can understand the 3 R's and practice it, then you don't have to worry about the jargons used in the industry. You know. You also look at the big multinational companies, brand owners who use plastic packaging. They also, in their policy document, they only talk about how to reduce, how to reuse, and how to recycle the material. When it comes to flexible packaging, let us understand, when we talk about reduce, what do you reduce actually? So here we talk about two things. One is source reduction and source substitution. Way back in 1995, people who are in this business, they would know Clinic Plus was packed in 12 micron polyester and 75 micron PE. Today, it is being packed under 12 micron polyester and 35 micron PE. So when I say source reduction, why to sell plastics when it is not required? Don't sell extra plastics. Just sell enough so that the intended use of the packaging is served. Many companies in these times, you know, were making profits by selling more and more plastics. So that was the plastic was the main business. Let us not do that. Let us design the packaging so that, you know, we just give enough packaging to service the intended service life. PepsiCo is a great example. So PepsiCo supplies one of the thinnest material in this planet for chips. You know, it is supplying anywhere between 42 and 48 GSM, over maybe 3,000 metric tons of laminate for chips which have high OTR and MVTR requirement in our country. Our country is very diverse in terms of geography, in terms of weather conditions. So, Lay's 10 rupees pack sold in Kerala has to perform equally as the one which is sold in Srinagar. So, design a pack for varied conditions and source reducing the source so much so is really a great effort. And this effort would not have been possible without the support of the industry. The industry also has to reciprocate in the same manner. So, here we talk about reduction. Another source reduction I could see, a lot of people in the Western world, they had switched over to reduction solvents, going into energy curing technologies. You know, you use energy to cure and cross-link the inks and the adhesives. So this is a great technology which can be a great source reduction parameter. Water-based inks, switching over to water-based inks is also one such step in this direction. So there are many opportunities for source reduction. So even if you, you know, we talk about big jargons like carbon footprint and GHG emissions, let us not worry about that. All the converting companies, all the flexible packaging industry just need to worry about source reduction. And we are moving ahead in the reduction of carbon footprint. When you talk about source substitution, you know, there are a lot of technology available in the country. Fortunately, you know, my experience is one of the finest packaging technology, finest packaging material is produced in India. You go to, I will not include Japan in this case because Japan is also very much advanced. But one of the finest barrier laminates, one of the finest laminates which can survive logistic hardships like our country, they are produced in India. So we are fortunate to have very good packaging. So here the source substitution will help. Why don't we try and eliminate aluminum foil? Why don't we try and eliminate paper? Paper is a very unfriendly material when it comes to sustainability. Deforestation, usage of tons of water for making 1 kg of paper. So there are a lot of opportunities here for the technology. I barrier, metallized BOPP, ALOX, EVOH-based BOPP, and still remaining under the CFLEX guidelines, we can produce material where at least I would say 60-65%, 70% of the aluminum foil can be replaced, or non-plastic packaging material which is non-recyclable can be replaced easily. So this is one step we should also think about. Use technology for source substitution. So here we cover the reduce part. When you talk about reuse, you know, again, India is one country where there is highest PET bottle recycle. You know? So these PET bottles, recycled PET bottle chips can be used to make recycled polyester. In Kentucky plant in Uflex in United States, we have produced 90% rPET, which means only 10% virgin material is used. And the line runs very stable. It runs at 450 meters per minute. All the gauges are under control. It has an FDA approval for food contact and all the necessary migration tests it is passing. So why don't we in India also we do? We here in India, Uflex, Noida, we use about 30% of recycled polyester. Imagine if such a vast industry of PET bottles, if some portion of this PET bottle chips can be used to make polyester. You know, India's packaging is predominantly polyester-based packaging. You can imagine the kind of service which we'll be doing to the nation in terms of less of imports and more of waste removal from the surface. Yes, yarn is a big industry. So all the PET bottles recycled today, 90-95% goes to making yarns. But packaging would be yielding more value than yarn if we try and divert some of these chips into the making the films. Also, there is now technology to use PE. You know, if you can use a MLP, a PE-based MLP or a PP-based MLP, there is a possibility to upscale it. You know, we have had instances where we have used up to 20% recycled PE in making the film. You know, upcycling is never a possibility because upcycling is very difficult. But for non-food applications, we can do recycling of PE, put it back to the PE. Maybe tomorrow we can do for PP. So if you can cover polyester and PE, which will cover about 60% of the total consumption of the in the country. So imagine 20% material of polyester and PE getting recycled and reused, the amount of foreign exchange we will be saving and the amount of waste we will not be seen on the surface of the planet. So when in last November, when Maharashtra Pollution Control Board came out with 20% usage of PCR material, we were all very excited. But for some reason, the industry did not take it very kindly, and you know they always put the restriction in terms of technology and FSSAI and all those things in front, so that we can somehow dodge use, you know, to and avoid using the multilayer plastic recycled material into the packaging. Third R is of course the recycling. Recycling technology is very advanced, as I keep saying in almost all the forums. There is a very popular myth that multilayered plastics cannot be recycled. It's absolutely myth. We recycle more than 20,000 metric tons of multilayered plastics. Multilayered plastics is mixed plastic with polyester, BOPP, poly, ink, adhesive, metallized, everything. In fact, we got an award way back in 1995 from the Swiss Davos Forum of Environment. So there is a technology available. All you need to do is to improvise the recycling technology a little bit here and there. And you can use this recycled content very much in the molded products, extruded molded products. So recycling. So these three R's, if you can practice, there is now a practical solution. It's not anymore theoretical. Yes, three R's can be practiced in India. And if India can do it, all other countries can do it. And I keep telling this, for sustainability, the West will have to look at East. Here we have the solutions. You know. So yes, people talk about chemical recycling. Yes, it is still under WIP. People are working on it. Nothing has been commercialized as of now. Biological recycling. You know, this is one area which will also come up very, very, very strongly in the coming days. If we can use the polyolefins and the fossil plastics and make it biodegradable, some way, you know, there will be technology which will come in definitely. And so this could be a very good biologically recyclable. But remember, the best countries in the world, they are not able to collect the full plastic waste from the environment. You know, the countries like Sweden and Denmark, they're small countries, a very organized system. They are not able to collect back more than 70% of the material. So collection and littering and the spillages will be life for us. You know, we will have to live with it for the entire life. So let us also talk about biological recycling, where this littered plastic can be converted into biomass and compost. So with this, I would like to just say that we did not worry. We did not worry too much about sustainability. All we need to follow is to find ways and means to remain in the umbrella of 3 R's: reduce, reuse, and recycle. Thank you so much.